You've done it. You've done it. All our Westminster targets have been accounted for. Albion's hurting and the people are coming out of their shells. I've even got a member of Parliament here contacting us.
Wait, what?
Yeah, I thought it strange too. Says she has an idea how we might rally the people in the borough. You should meet her.
I can't believe Albion had the brass to spatter their propaganda all over Buckingham Palace. When this is all over, maybe there'll be a knighthood in it for me. Sir Bagley has a ring, doesn't it? Feel free to use it any time.
Deep breath, get out of here. Every villain in this city. the pink box.
Need out. Where's something on?
You trying to track down DedSec? How come?
Wasn't sure you'd come, knowing I'm part of the establishment. Or at least I was, until Albion dismissed Parliament. I do want to say, what you've done in Westminster is remarkable. You've given the people hope.
Whatever the government's screwing up, that's nothing new. Albion stomping all over this city is the real sticky situation now.
I couldn't agree more. That's why I contacted you. Albion haven't simply shut down the government. They've sullied the Palace of Westminster, the Great Bell, with their propaganda. Do you understand what that looks like? If you really want to rekindle some of the people's fighting spirit, then restoring the clock tower would go a long way.
Hell yeah! We'd be giving the power back to the people and sending a big V sign to Albion. I'm in.
I knew I could count on you. It will be wonderful to hear the bell once more.
There is some security around the bell tower, but that shouldn't pose a problem. A bigger issue will be getting to the top.
What should I do?
A spider bot should do the trick. Tower is treacherous. All crawl spaces and gantries. More suited to 6 mechanical legs than 2 human ones.
My kind of fun.
Thank you.
Was moving, truly. To hear the chimes again, to see that tower the way it's meant to be seen, means everything to the people of this borough.
Same. I'd love to hear those bells chime. It's not just the clock tower, is it? It's so much more than that.
It represents our parliamentary democracy. To have Albion deface it the way they did, it's clear what they were up to. Thank you, Deadsec. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Brilliantly done. Westminster will surely rise up against Albion after this.
Cool. Cheers.
Auto-drive now enabled. You're listening to me, Tash, on Buccaneer.
Your auto-drive now disabled. To know.
This time we're turning our focus back on the media to look at my former employer, the GBB. As we know, the broadcaster has been through a lot of changes since the Hassani government gave in to pressure from his corporate back. And privatized the corporation. Today, the GBB is a shadow of its former self. It's become a tool used by the government to circulate fake news and misinformation. So how did we get here? Where did it all go wrong? How can we tell when our national media has become state propaganda? Our experts speak on conditions of anonymity for their own safety. Here's disinformation and media expert Charles, who's seen free broadcasters built up by journalists and torn down by demagogues all over the world.
So before the media fragmented, there was this voice of authority that was trusted and worthy of trust. Then what we ended up with is a really commercial model where whether you're talking about an app on a smart device or whether you're talking about a broadcaster, the most important thing was to keep you in that environment for the longest amount of time possible. And because that meant money in their pocket. And in order to do that, a couple of things happened. One was the use of manipulative techniques around behavioral economics, things that would just keep you scrolling or keep you listening or keep you looking for more information. The second is that that kind of environment favors sensationalism. And And so you got more sensational headlines and more sensational stories, and it didn't matter whether they were true or not. It just kept people in, and it kept them in the loop. So we ended up in a situation where nobody trusted anything, and nobody believed anything at all. And that is the perfect environment for an authoritarian voice to come in and say, no, wait, we are the truth. So the ground for this environment really got created when we had suddenly authoritarian politicians everywhere, and anything that threatened them or they disagreed with, they would call it disinformation. That's disinformation, that's fake news. And again, we got in a situation where nobody really believed anything. And the trouble is if you were telling the truth, it's very hard to get your message to cut through all of the noise of all of the disinformation that's there. So like, you know, you remember out on the edges, there was this story about when they would take a house by force, they would take any infants and they would crucify them. And that's a great, fantastic, viral story. And how do you counter that story? With the truth. The only way you can counter it is by saying, no, they didn't. And of course, no one wants this.
Auto drive now disabled.
No one wants to hear that story. They want to hear the sensationalism. They want to hear how people were victims of violence when in fact they weren't. Or they were victims of insurgent forces when in fact they weren't.
Auto drive now enabled.
It's a battleground. Here's media researcher and academic Alfie.
The media has, of course, been perhaps the key way in which governments have controlled and influenced their populations. So, you know, totalitarian countries have typically used huge mainstream media to sell one kind of news, one kind of news to its population. Of course, the media has always played this kind of key role in methods of state control. I think what's happening now is perhaps even more concerning, where you previously, in pre-crisis Britain, we had perhaps more diverse voices in the media, but now with the GBB, you're really only seeing one brand of news and therefore only getting one truth. So people end up with a very biased and controlled idea of the reality and the world of reality. Of course, the media is turning.
Investigating disturbance. Target malfunctioning.
French and support the
auto drive.
Thank you. What was that?
You brute!
Thank you.
just a bit. This barber, so on and so forth.
Now the plebs just spout about.
What do we have, Bags?
It appears Albion has mapped out the locations of a number of dissidents in the city. I doubt they're planning their Christmas card list. I'll make sure someone sends a warning.